wrestling fans, and welcome once again to USWA's Championship Wrestling. Now, you know, every week on the program, we go over some of the greatest matches, and we see some of the finest action anywhere in the world, and we go all over the world to get this action. Well, this week here at the USWA, something very different and very unique has occurred. I'm talking about General Skandar Akbar and his Devastation Incorporated trying to woo the services of Jeff Jarrett into his camp. We'll be telling you all the background on that and bringing you up to date on what has transpired in the USWA. Also, we'll see the Wild Things. This is a tag team that's been put together, and they are tough. Jeff Gaylord and Scott Braddock. We'll see Joey Maggs and his partner Rex King in action. We'll also see Billy Joe Travis and many more USWA stars. It's an hour of action. We want you to stay right where you are. We'll take a look at the first action right after these messages. Started a few weeks back. Let's go back a couple of weeks as Skandar Akbar offering money for top stars, including Jeff Jarrett, to join Devastation Incorporated. Jeff offers to take Akbar up on this generous offer by the general. Let's take a look and see what transpired.
Mac, last week you came out here and you offered everybody that was here last Saturday a $5,000, right? Just a sign with Devastation, is that correct?
That's correct.
All right. Another thing you also stated was that if you could sign me, I would be the one man to beat Jerry Lawler.
That's correct. That's correct. Yes.
That I would be the one man to bring the World Heavyweight Championship around my waist, right? I would be the one man to bring the Unified World Belt right into Devastation's camp, is that right?
That is correct. I said all along that you were one of the finest athletes ever to grace the squared circle.
Well, I know you're an intelligent man because you do have a lot of money. But one thing, it seems that if I'm going to be the man to bring the belt into your camp, don't you think I'm worth a little bit more than $5,000?
Money. Money's no object, Jeff. Let's make it double. Let's make it $10,000 for signing this morning. Also, we'll negotiate the extensive contract a little later on at Devastation's camp, but $10,000, you got it this morning, Jeff Jarrett.
A $10,000 signing bonus?
A signing bonus for $10,000. Laid out to Jeff Jarrett.
$10,000.
Now this check, before I give you this check, you realize business is business. You know that.
Yes. Strictly business.
One of your first duties today, I have a tag team event scheduled for later on here tonight on Championship Sports with Sheik Braddock and Jeff Gaylord. But I have dreamed and dreamed and dreamed that the greatest tag combination in the history of wrestling would be Jeff Gaylord and Jeff Jarrett. You will team with Jeff Gaylord today with a Missouri Tiger. Here's your check for $10,000. You are now a member of Devastation Incorporated.
A $10,000 sign, boss?
Exactly.
What now, boss? We got the tag match?
Tag match with Jeff Gaylord.
Let's go.
I honestly don't know what to say. The music says that he's simply irresistible, but apparently Jeff Jarrett couldn't resist the money of Skandar Akbar. Now, Akbar's dream team of the Jeffs, Jeff Gaylord and Jeff Jarrett, will take on Billy Joe Travis and Terry Usher. Jeff Jarrett steps into the ring. Billy Joe Travis trying to talk some sense into him, but Jeff Jarrett, the newest member of Devastation Incorporated, and I didn't think that I'd ever say anything like that. But it is a formidable team nonetheless. The two Jeffs, the Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord, and simply irresistible Jeff Jarrett. Skandor Akbar has quite a coup here. And Gaylord misses with a lockup. That's Terry Usher in the ring against the Missouri Tiger. And Usher hits him with a dropkick. But Gaylord answers with a double axe handle. Now Gaylord power slam takes Terry Usher down. And now some posing by Jeff Gaylord. He likes to do that, show off that well-built body. Gaylord sets Usher up to the super and nails him. And now the posing Jeff Gaylord. If he was in a dance club, they'd say he was the voguing Jeff Gaylord. Belly to back suplex, nails Usher. Skandor Akbar yells over me, says, what a combination. This is his dream team. And now posing once again is Jeff Gaylord, but he doesn't see Billy Joe Travis. And Travis in the ring, ready to take on Jeff Gaylord. They lock up. Travis sends him into the corner. Big right hook. Now a combination in the midsection. Billy Joe Travis taking off on Jeff Gaylord. Now he sends him. Oh, no, reversal. Gaylord gets him. Picks him up. And he gets set to put him down. Down hard goes Billy Joe Travis. And now, Jeff Jarrett. Oh, Jeff Jarrett playing the choreographer here, telling Jeff Gaylord to pose for the, now pose for the other corner. Jeff Gaylord, no, one for this side. Jeff Jarrett says, pose for me now. Oh! Jeff Jarrett hits him with a dropkick. Now he goes to the second rope. Maybe there is hope after all. Jarrett nails him. Travis goes to the bed. One, two, three. And now Jarrett nails Akbar.
I don't like poses. I don't like Gaylord. And I don't like you. And most of all, I don't take orders very good.
Then the next week here on Championship Wrestling, Akbar and Devastation Incorporated went way overboard in an attempt to get even. Let's take a look.
You know, Percy, today happens to be a very, 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 very special day. As you can tell, because you're such a smart individual, we're all dressed in our party attire. We're ready to rock and roll. But I want to tell you people why we're out here to party. Mr. Akbar, if you step up here, baby, if you'll step up here, you may not, you know, we brought all this stuff out to you and said, what's going on? And we said, surprise. Well, you may not know, this happens to be the 10th year anniversary of Devastation Incorporated, and I'm happy to say that I've been a very proud part of it for the last 2.5 years, and maybe a little longer, and I just want you to know, we're here today with cake and presents and everything. And I'd like to bestow upon you right now something that means so very much to all of us. And I know it'll mean something to you because it's got your symbol on it. And if the camera's taking a nice look at this nice money clip, this is for you and all your hard-earned cash, all your hard-earned efforts. And you got to admit, this is a day to celebrate. What do you think, Percy?
And I'm happy to be a part of it.
You know, in this country, all you read about is the failure of savings and loans and banks. The USA is one big failure, but one organization that will never fail is Devastation Incorporated. The 10th anniversary and this is party time. I want everybody to have a good time. The Angel of Death, Sergeant Fury, Chico. Oh, yeah, we've got the chips. Yeah, Frankie.
Can I have one?
Yeah,
party!
It's certainly party time for Devastation. Everybody have a good time. Oh, yeah, look at that. I love it. Yeah, Percy, you know, you and I have had our differences, but I want you to have a good time, Percy.
Thank you. I love parties.
Chico, I know that you had something that you wanted to present to me. You had something that you wanted to present to me, Chico.
That's right, Mr. Akbar. You was after me for a long time, Mr. Akbar. And one morning I woke up and I saw the light. And I couldn't be very happy to be with Devastation. So I went to Grandma Torres' house. And she stayed up all night making this special hot sauce for you.
Oh, very good. Thank you, Chico. Let's try some of this hot sauce.
Let me have a dip of that, Act. Let me have a dip.
Yeah, yeah. Everybody help yourself.
Jerry! Whoa! It's hot! It's hot, man! It's hot!
Chico! That pork in my mouth!
Ah. Woo! That'll burn the hair off of you, man.
You see, when you're in Devastation, you enjoy the good parts of life. You don't have to open the newspaper and see how the United States is one big failure. Because I give you people class when Devastation comes and all these great, great, superior athletes appear before your television camera. As I said before, Percy, you know, help yourself. This is a party. You and I have had our differences, but I want you to lay it all aside. I'm so happy. I'm so very, very happy.
General, yeah. I guess with that hot sauce there.
Oh, is it hot?
You might say we're the hottest thing going, baby.
Hey, and this hot sauce is made, I believe, here in Texas, so it's got to be real hot. Chico's grandma made it. Yeah, Chico's grandma made it.
It's good, but it's hot.
Jeff Jarrett trying to work his way through the throng of fans, trying to get a hug, trying to get an autograph, trying to get a picture. As he works his way right behind me, right to the steps. Devastation had a party, Jeff.
And I wasn't invited.
Did you want to be invited?
I cannot believe Akbar didn't invite me to this party. You care if I believe I'm just going to invite myself.
This is the leftovers. Have what you want.
You don't care?
It ain't mine.
He wouldn't care, would he?
Huh? Have you a bite of this hot sauce?
Is it hot?
Hot, huh? Ooh. That'd take a paint off the car, wouldn't it, Jeff? Some hot stuff.
How come Akbar didn't invite me? Me and him were just like that.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. Just like me and Kerry Von Erich are like that. Oh, wait a minute. Maybe you're going to be invited. Here comes General Akbar. Wait a minute.
This is a private party as far as you're concerned, Jarrett. You see, I thought you learned your lesson when I got my money back that was rightfully mine all along. But it looks like you're a glutton for punishment, Jeff. This is a private party. I don't know what you're doing down here, but I suggest you get in the ring and have your match.
Ack, I can't understand why you didn't invite me. Me and you've had some good business dealings, hadn't we?
Well, that's true, yeah. Yeah. Yeah, in your own mind, it's good business deal, but you know, the old genius always comes out on top. You got to admit that. Yeah, you know that, Jeff, huh?
Well, Ack, you know what? Ack, this might come a little surprise to you, but I do respect you. And you know, 10 years is an awful long time to have the same wrestling organization, right, Percy? I mean, that's something really to be proud of. And I even respect that, Ack. I really do. And you know what? I even got you a present. I sure did. I got you a present.
You got me a present.
Oh, come on, Jeff. Come on, Jeff. Don't do that. He's took the whole thing of chips and dumped it right over General Skandar Akbar's head. Well, here I am again in the middle of things. I won't say a word. I'll try to remain neutral. The dog of war. The dog of war, a member of Devastation Incorporated. There's the bell sounded by timekeeper James Walden, as General Akbar heads up the aisle with chips all over his turban, or whatever you want to call it. Dogger Ward runs in. Jeff Jarrett. Jeff moves out of the way just in the nick of time. Collar and elbow locked up. Snatches that headlock. He shoots him out. Here it comes. A hard elbow. Dogger Ward goes down. They square off. All the USWA fans here in the building this morning getting behind the chant. Let's go, Jeff. Everybody loves Jeff Jarrett. The pride of Nashville, Tennessee. Right in the deep south. Music City, USA, Jeff Jarrett. Sure won the hearts of these fans here in the USWA. Tip toss by Jeff Jarrett since Buster Blackheart, the Dog of War. Complaining to Bronco Lubich. Dog of War dressed out in his red and white tights. He said he pulled his tights. I don't know. Here I am again. It's like deja vu of a few weeks ago, trying to stay in the middle of things. Trying not to take sides. Collar and elbow lockup. Dog of War pushes Jeff Jarrett back into the rope. Hard body slam by Simply Irresistible Jeff Jarrett. Dog of War holding on to those ropes. It don't look like he wants any more, Mr. Jeff Jarrett. What action here on Championship Sports this evening on USWA Wrestling. The big party with Devastation Incorporated was just almost ruined here a minute ago. But Jeff Jarrett took that bowl of chips and put it right over General Skandar Akbar's head. Jeff was kind of laughing there when he said that they had some good business dealings in the past. You know what happened a couple of weeks ago when Jeff made off with a check from the General's checkbook. Jeff Jarrett snatches that arm. It's a reversal by the Dog of War. Oh, he's got him in a small package. Two, three. Wait a minute. Here comes Sweet Daddy Falcone. Here comes gorgeous Gary Young down the aisle. I see General Skandar Akbar coming. I see the Angel of Death. Oh, no, I hope this doesn't result. No, wait a minute. We can't have this. Jeff Jarrett, he's cleaning house. He's cleaning house. The Angel of Death, General Skandar Akbar down here on the floor. He's given a signal. He gave a signal. Wait a minute. Here comes Chico Torres. Chico Torres. He's sneaking up. Wait a minute. Let me get out of the way. Don't do this. What are you going to do? Don't do that. Don't do that. He's grabbed the hot sauce. He's got that hot sauce. And man, it's hot. I know it's hot. What is he going to do? He's got a handful of it. He put it in his eyes. He put it in his eyes. He put this hot patina sauce right directly in Jeff Jarrett's eyes. Man, I know how hot this stuff is because I tried some of it. Jeff Jarrett has to be in severe pain as he's writhing on the dentist. Here comes, there it go. There it go, Travis Hickory. And Devastation runs away. Man. Billy Joe Travis has a towel. Trying to help Jeff Jarrett the best he can, but I don't know what good that dry towel's going to do to Tiso. That's some hot sauce there. Some of the hottest that I've ever tasted it. Wait, he grabs some water from a fan.
He ain't going to mess up our party.
Gary Young says he's not messing up our party.
It's so pretty now, isn't it, Percy?
Now Jeff Jarrett has had an entire week to get ready to pay back what Devastation Incorporated has done to him. And he and Billy Joe Travis will get that payback opportunity. They'll take on Devastation Incorporated with General Skandar Akbar. We're going to take a quick break, hear from Jeff Jarrett. We'll be back right after this.
Akbar and all of Devastation Incorporated, I'm talking to you.
You know, I've been wrestling about 4 years, if you didn't know. And it seems that I've seen an awful lot of things, been in a whole lot of different type of matches, and been against a bunch of different opponents. And yeah, I feel like I've done pretty good against them. But you, Akbar, you tried to take it all away from me. You tried to take my eyesight. That's right. I've got a dream, and one day I'm going to realize it. One day I'm going to be the world heavyweight champion. But Akbar, you tried to take it all away. Yeah, this eye over here, I have to put drops in it 3 times a day and keep a patch over it. And this eye, I have to keep putting drops in it to keep the infection out. Well, Akbar, I'm not making any threats. I'm just making a promise right to you. You're going to wish you never saw that hot sauce, because I've got payback this week.
USWA Championship Wrestling returns to the Evansville Coliseum this Wednesday night. Opening action, Scott Braddock takes on Ben Jordan. You'll see Kawabunga versus Johnny Hotbody. The Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord versus superstar Bill Dundee. The USWA World Tag Team Championship will be on the line when Hotshot Joey Mag teams with Southern rocker Rex King to do battle with the Dirty White Boys, Tony Anthony and Tom Burton, with the Dirty White Girl in their corner. Then the main event in Evansville Wednesday night, the grudge match of the year. Jeff Jarrett seeks his revenge, and he has the match signed as his partner Billy Joe Travis and Jeff Jarrett team together to go against General Skandar Akbar's Devastation Incorporated. Catch all the action this Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum. Tag team action, including the USWA Tag Championship, on the line. The TV studio out of Memphis, Tennessee, is bustling with action today from the USWA. Let's go to it.
Edie Steele over on the right of your screen. Ken Raper, his partner, right in the middle of the screen. And over on the left, referee Jerry Calhoun. Hear the music. Here comes the Dirty White Girl leading the Dirty White Boys. Tony Anthony and Tom Burton as they head for ringside. The former USWA World Tag Team Champions. They don't have the belts anymore.
And I can assure you that's going to make them be in a nasty mood today, Dave.
Unfortunately, I'm afraid you're exactly right. Tony Anthony, Tom Burton going against T.D. Steele and Ken Raper. It's Burton starting against Steele. Steele into the rope, steps over Burton. Burton lets him go by again. T.D. leaps over, waits. Nice move. T.D. Steele takes him down to the mat. Over to the corner.
T.D. Steele is so energetic. He's so full of himself. I like that guy. Look at him. He's like his own cheerleading squad.
He is indeed, and, he gives away a lot of size. Oh, my goodness, Ken Raper just ran into a telephone pole and a brick wall all at the same time from Burton. Burton makes the tag, and here comes Tony Anthony, the Dirty White Boy. A chop with a right hand. Ken Raper almost turned a flip there by Tony Anthony.
Now here comes Bundy the Gorilla around here. Look.
Bundy's got his eye on the Dirty White Girl, I think.
Yeah.
Raper up in the air, body slam by Tony Anthony. Tag made, and the Dirty White Boys double team. Meanwhile, Bundy the Gorilla. Oh, my goodness. Trying to offer roses to the Dirty White Girl. Tony Anthony saw what was going on and came down and frightened the Gorilla away.
These guys are just in an all-around bad mood. They don't even like the mascot out here.
Boy, you're right. They're in a nasty mood today. They lost the belts a week ago right here on television.
Raper needs to try to tag out and get T.D. Steele back. Oh, my gosh. Look out.
Oh, boy. Anthony with a cover. This may be it. Count is 2, 3. Wow. It's all over. The Dirty White Boys in 1:45 have just defeated Ken Raper and T.D. Steele.
They want Rex King and Joey Maggs out here.
Well, Rex King and Joey Maggs have got another match scheduled, and it is not against these guys. And we'd appreciate it if you guys would leave the area right now. You've got a victory in the match, 1:45 the time. And this match, history as the Dirty White Boys get themselves yet another victory.
From the USWA Broadcast Center, you see the best in championship wrestling each and every week from all over the world. We've got action featuring part of Devastation Incorporated, Sweet Daddy Falcone, and Chico Torres. Let's go to the Sportatorium in Dallas, Texas.
The opponents, Jim Warren, and J.P. Muhala. That's Jim Ward in the ring right now, ready to face off against Sweet Daddy Falcone. Tony Falk is your referee. And gorgeous Gary Young lays 10 on Chico Torres, and now it's a confab. General?
What an excitement. I can't remember that two matches held in the same week here in the Sportatorium. It's going to be a historic week. Of course, those nights will live in infamy for certain individuals like Jarring Jeff Jarrett and Billy Joe, the ungrateful traitor Travis. You know what I'm talking about. And that battle royal, I can't believe this is going to be the biggest battle royal in the history of Dallas wrestling. And I can't wait. I want to be in that battle royal, Craig. You know the reason why? Because when devastation mops up the squared circle, they're all going to come and shine my boots. Shine my boots, because I'm the general, the godfather, and gorgeous Gary here is this superstar, and he's charged up for Wednesday, and he's charged up for Friday, Gary.
Woo! You were here last night, Greg. You see how I whooped that Von Erich from pillar to post all the way out the building. Now he had to run back in and try to jump it from the backside. Never fails, though. He's gone. But I tell you what, let's get up here in this match. You want Sweet Daddy Falcone here. Well, Kevin can dream every day of the rest of his life. It's what he does for a major living anyway. He doesn't spend a whole lot of time thinking about his wrestling ability. It's well known that he has none.
Oh, our guest color commentator, gorgeous Gary Young.
He missed a great party last week, didn't he, gorgeous Gary? Of course, Jeff Jarrett tried to be the little fly in the white, but we made him an insect, didn't we?
You know, General, Billy Travis starting to bite off more than he can chew now, too, you know.
He made him.
We made Billy Travis. He never looked so good until he stood beside me.
Hardy was that good, huh?
Hardy was great.
You like hot sauce?
Oh, heck
yeah.
Ask Jeff what it tastes like.
All right.
Of course, he's a little sloppy. He got some in his eyes. I don't know. Bowl spilt on his head or something.
I saw the video, thank you. Well, it seems like Jim Ward has the best of Sweet Daddy right here. Barring that arm. If you're going to be a color commentator, would you like some headphones also, sir? We're going to make Gary Young into a television commentator.
I'm already a household name, so it wouldn't be take much, you know. You got to straighten up this collar and tie. You look a little pathetic on TV sometimes. I'll have to teach you a little finer aspect of how to dress in public, I guess.
I do, at least I wear glasses and not contacts when I'm around you.
Well, then glasses gotta help. Don't give you much sense.
Ah! Jim Ward has some sense. As he takes charge on Sweet Daddy Falcone, devastation. Not getting the best of this one.
Well, you know, Jeff, though, this Jim Ward hadn't been around in a while. It looks like he's been doing some homework. Looks like he's been out wrestling around the country a little bit. He's improved a heck of a lot since the last time he was here. It's been 6 or 7 months at least, and you can definitely see the improvement. But I tell you what, don't put devastation down, Sweet Daddy. It'll just be a matter of time.
And the tag to gorgeous. I'm so used to you being here. That's Chico Torres, maybe not gorgeous unless you happen to follow that.
That's okay, Greg. You have a lot of difficulties with names. Why you answer to Jethro so often?
Take a week off, it happens. Chico Torres, the man who says he's the best Latin American wrestler there is. Your opinions on that, Gary?
Well, there's no doubt about it. Chico Perez is definitely one of the most improved wrestlers, and since he's come into the Devastation Camp, we've had him in the ring working out, teaching him the finer secrets to being a top sport.
There's the backdrop. Torres sets him up. Oh, that's a big clothesline.
One of the finer points I was just talking about.
Let's take a break right here when we get an opportunity. But a series of elbows to the side of the head. Action hot and heavy, not able to take a break right exactly here, but we'll have one coming up here.
You know, Chico's got one of the most unusual suplexes around. Not many people are strong enough and talented enough to be able to take a guy and just drop him in midair like that, but Chico does a fine job. You can tell he's hitting the weights.
And here is J.P. Muhala. First time I've seen J.P. here. Chico Torres gets the tag to one of the biggest men in USWA wrestling, Sweet Daddy Falcon. And it's just built from head to toe.
You know, you can really tell the difference between the time Jim Ward got out of the ring and this J.P.M., whatever his name is, got in the ring. It's obvious to me that he's no match for El Falcon or Chico Torres.
Let's take a break. You won't miss any of the action because we'll be back right after this.
USWA Championship Wrestling returns to the Evansville Coliseum this Wednesday night. Opening action, Scott Braddock takes on Ben Jordan. You'll see Kawabunga versus Johnny Hotbody. The Missouri Tiger, Jeff Gaylord versus superstar Bill Dundee. The USWA World Tag Team Championship will be on the line when Hotshot Joey Mag teams with Southern Rocker Rex King to do battle with the Dirty White Boys, Tony Anthony and Tom Burton, with the Dirty White Girl in their corner. Then the main event in Evansville Wednesday night, the grudge match of the year. Jeff Jarrett seeks his revenge, and he has the match signed as his partner Billy Joe Travis and Jeff Jarrett team together to go against General Skandar Akbar's Devastation Incorporated. Catch all the action this Wednesday night, the Evansville Coliseum. Tag team action, including the USWA Tag Championship, on the line.
Shoulder block by JP. Hop over. Torres. Oh! Torres still got the kickoff, and that shows you a little bit of the power of the legs of Chico Torres.
Well, Devastation is definitely in control once again. As usual, week after week, we always come out and show the best that they have.
There's the tag to Sweet Daddy Falcon. And Chico, little double teaming, but I will give you your credit.
What do you mean double teaming?
You have a count of four. Yeah, count of four, and then you have to break by five.
When they did
Chico,
that.
I was saying.
So what'd you bring it up for?
Well,
if it don't mean nothing, what'd you bring it up for? If he broke legally within 4 seconds.
That move by Sweet Daddy could break a few things.
Yeah, Sweet Daddy, he's been known to break a few bones in his day, and if this boy keeps trying to get up, he might not have any bones left to be broke.
Sweet Daddy Falcon lets him get up, but puts him right down to the canvas. And the big elbow nails JP. One, and JP kicked out.
Coffin with you.
I don't know any Undertakers.
Oh, you don't?
Actually, I do know one, but I think he's out of the business. But?
Well, we may have to re-get his license back here, because I tell you what, Kevin's going to need an Undertaker or a pallbearer or something.
Your boss is a happy man.
He's got every right to be. Devastation's on the road. We're on top again. You know, we had about a month here where things didn't go our way, but now that we've got our control back, got Sweet Daddy Falcon, Chico Torres, yours too. What else can you say?
It took a lot for the general to finally convince Chico. What do you think was that final thing to get him a member of his Devastation Incorporated? Was it the money, the intimidation, or what was it?
The intimidation probably paid a small part of it. But Chico's a smart man. He thinks dollars and cents, you know? And the basic bottom line is dollars and cents.
Or pesos.
Hey. He's an American.
Oh, okay. Chico Torres looking for the tag. And JP gets the suplex.
I'm going to take a break here. I'm going to get on my team here and make sure they get things on a roll here.
All right. The gorgeous one leaves ringside table, makes his way over the corner as Chico Torres finally dispatches J.P. Muha. And Chico gets a tag on his own. Now it's Jim Ward being offered the hand of friendship by Sweet Daddy Falcon. I wouldn't do it. Oh, Chico distracts him, and then he gets a boot to the midsection. Sweet Daddy Falcon with the right hand. He gets the tag to Chico Torres. Torres makes his way in, chops with the left hand. One more time by Chico. There's the tag. Sweet Daddy Falcon comes in, and oh, the devastation clothesline. One, two, three. And your winners, Devastation Incorporated, Sweet Daddy Falcon, and Chico Torres. But they're not finished yet. Mulala goes into La La Land with a clothesline, and Gary Young now on the floor, taking care of Mulala. Oh, a body slam to the floor. Then a series of boots. Gorgeous Gary Young and Devastation. Now, this is out of control. Let's take a break for this special word. We'll be back right after this.
I'm using this other...
We're back at USWA Championship Wrestling's Broadcast Center. Billy Joe Travis is one of the finest wrestlers that has ever stepped foot into the USWA. He's ready for action now in Dallas, Texas. Let's go back to the Sportatorium.
Billy Joe Travis facing off against the Dog of War as he brings his chain into the ring. Says he has the best right hand in wrestling. Hot property, Billy Joe Travis, who has always has a hello for somebody, and this week it's Miss Millie Lee Stone he wanted to say hello to. Billy Joe Travis with some scores to settle with Devastation, including Chico Torres, Sweet Daddy Falcon, and the chairman of the board, Andor Akbar. The two face off. Back to the corner they go. The Dog of War. With a shot to the midsection one more time. And the Dog of War. And there's that right hand. Taking charge of the Dog of War. Snaps his head back. And this dog's cowering into the doghouse. Into the ring he goes. That's Bronco Lou. It's two. What's the fifth? Well, I had a right hook like Billy Joe Travis does. I'd probably have my opponent watch out for it too. They lock up collar and elbow. Nice go behind into the full Nelson by Billy Joe Travis. As he locks up the Dog of War, but a nice reversal by the Dog of War. He's got the full Nelson off. Snapmare. There's an offer of friendship. Billy Joe Travis doesn't quite fall for that one. Now they go behind, and he brings him over on the roll. One, but that's all, as the Dog of War practically comes into your living room trying to escape from that one. And isn't that a nasty thought? Billy Joe Travis locks up the left arm, twisting that wrist, which puts a lot of pressure on the elbow. The Dog of War, one wrestler you can tell without a program, due to the tattoo on that arm. And a handful of hair brings Billy Joe Travis down, and a leg drop on the left arm. Travis shakes it off.
and then goes back to work on the dog of war. Twisting that arm. Has it locked up nicely. But the dog of war goes to the rope, trying to break it, instead goes to the corner, rakes the eyes of Hot Property. Now the dog of war with a right of his own. That one landed nicely. Billy Joe Travis checking to see if he needs to go to the Genesis Bridge. And checks again. Over the top rope. The throat of Billy Joe Travis. That cuts off your breathing. That'll cut off your wrestling ability a lot, too. There's the suplex and the not-so-great cover of the Dog of War, only is good for a count of two. Shinlock on Billy Joe Travis by the Dog of War. Video Bob won't even have to put a name key on this one. It's just written right there in front of you. Billy Joe Travis, after doling out the punishment earlier, is taking some punishment in this one. Still the Dog of War in charge, has the pressure on the side of the head of Billy Joe Travis. Both wrestlers extremely fatigued. They've both taken quite a punishment. And after last night's match with Devastation, Billy Joe Travis doing his best to take care of business. And oh, that roundhouse right. Nails the Dog of War one more time. Billy Joe Travis sends him into the ropes of the Dog of War. Oh, did you hear that kick? Land on the back of the Dog of War. There's a count of one, two. Put the dog to sleep. This one's done. Your winner, Billy Joe Travis.
From the Lone Star State to the city by the river, we're going to Memphis, Tennessee for action featuring the Snowman, one of the toughest competitors Jerry the King Lawler has had to face in many, many years, perhaps his career. Snowman's ready for action in Memphis. Let's go right now to that action.
Tim Hall already right there. We're ready to go. This, of course, a non-title match as Tim Hall waits there along with the referee, Jerry Calhoun. Calhoun, not favorite referee of the Snowman either. Here we go. It's going to be one fall, 10-minute time limit. Wayne, jump in there when you want to with a little play-by-play with us here. Snowman, as you said, you've talked to many times on the radio.
Yeah. He's complaining we don't put him on the radio. We put him on there every week, you know. Mm-hmm. Just like,
My goodness gracious, Snowman came out of the ring post there and nailed Tim Hall with a right fist.
As a matter of fact, I told Snowman the other day, I promised him an interview Monday, and he knows that's when he's going on, is Monday morning, you know. So.
He's in there right now against Tim Hall. Hall back under the ropes. Snowman fires him across the way, grabs him, and power slams him down to the mat. Count is two. This may be it. Three. This one's all over.
Talk about a quick match, Dave.
A quick one indeed for the champion. Snowman in about 18 seconds. Oh, now, wait a minute. A right fist.
That's uncalled for right there.
It is absolutely uncalled for. The match is all over. Snowman has won the match. But he continues to beat up on Tim Hall. There he goes again, kicking him.
Now, is that the way a champion should handle himself, Dave?
Well, not in my mind, no.
I don't think so either.
Snowman with that right fist picks Tim Hall up and knocks him down again. Now Snowman leaves the ring.
That's your USWA United Heavyweight Champion, Snowman.
That's it, the World Unified Champion right there. Snowman has the victory. Again, the time on it is 18 seconds. At
Jerry Lawler, you tell Dave Brown what I said. That's for Lawler.
Snowman said that was for Jerry Lawler there.
Obviously, the Snowman, a tough customer, getting harder by the minute. Just he's a, gosh, what a wrestler he is. Let's take this break. More USWA action right after this. Tony
down say they've already added a match this week, and I'd like you, that dirty little white girl, just to take a look why they've added it. Eddie Marlin's already signed it, and it's taken place.
And indeed with a pin cover. Had a count of two, the white girl in here with that whip. Nails Dundee in the stomach, but look at this, we've got a fight. Break it out on our hands, the white girl and Tessa, all over each other, all in each other's hair over there.
Well, you had to figure this was going to happen. Dundee just tosses the white girl off. Sonny Anthony trying to grab his woman. Dundee grabbing his. They're ripping clothes. And there they go again. White girl right back in on Tessa. They're pulling each other's hair, pulling their clothes.
The white girl in there wanting a piece of Tessa. They're going after each other, pulling hair, pulling clothes. White girl finally snatches her down on the mat.
Now, Tony, you know exactly why that match is taking place, and white girl, somebody's got something to say to you.
If you can come down to the matches and conduct yourself like a lady, dirty white girl, which I don't think you can, then everything will be all right between me and you. But if you as much as step 1 foot into that ring or interfere in any way, I will rip every hair out of your head, scratch your eyeballs out, and knock your teeth into the ground.
You got that, little white girl, you got that. Now, Tony Anthony, let me tell you something, punk. You got $12,000 riding on my head off John Tatum, and he's goofy, and you're just as goofy as you think you're going to collect it. Well, this may start off a single, and I think it's going to end up a tag match. It's lights out. Anything goes, so you can bring a stick, a chain, anything you want to the ring. And I'm telling you up front, brother, that's exactly what I'm going to do, because you're not collecting no bounty. It starts off a single match, and I think Miss Tessa and white girl will finish it off.
We're set to go back to Memphis, Tennessee. Tag team action as Joey Maggs and Rex King, one strong tag team, takes on one of the best in the USWA, the Wild Things, Jeff Gaylord and Scott Braddock. Let's go back to Memphis, Tennessee.
We're just about set to go with an expiration of time match. And I'm sorry to tell you, fans, we don't have a whole lot of time for the match. I wish we had a lot more. But we're going to wrestle as long as we've got time for it. As Maggs and Rex King are in there against this team of the Wild Things. Jeff Gaylord, the Missouri Tiger, against Rex King right now. Look at Rex. Move him around in here. Jeff Gaylord with the upper arm. Rex King coming back. Well, Bruno says that's a tag team. That's one thing.
How does Bruno get a tag team like this? What I want.
I don't know, but they are an awesome-looking tag team, let me tell you. Gaylord, boy, nice move there from Rex King. He really slowed Gaylord down quite a bit. Oh, no, here come the dirty white boys jumping Joey Maggs from behind, and Rex King. They lost the belts to these guys, so what do? They come in here and interfere, for heaven's sake. We need to get this stopped. Eight against, what is it? Oh, four against two is what it is. How about going in there and get this stopped, please? You said you were going to be a good guest when you came out here today. So Gary is up in the ring. Let's see here if he can bring order back. Danny? Well, it looks like maybe he's done it. They backed off. Will they leave the area? Looks like they're leaving the area. As they head back to the dressing room, we've got to take a quick break, and we'll be back with you in just a moment. Thanks.
Wrestling fans, I don't know about you, but for me, this hour goes by so fast. We're all out of time again. Hope you've enjoyed all the action. This week at the arenas, first of all, Jeff Jarrett gets his shot at Devastation Incorporated. General Skandar Akbar is behind a lot of weird things, and Jeff Jarrett finally gets his shot with Billy Joe Travis in his corner in tag team action at the arena. You'll want to see that. Plus, the world tag team titles on the line, the Dirty White Boys up against Joey Maggs and Rex King, and they have made quite a combination since coming on the scene here at the USWA. Jerry the King Lawler continues his feud for the Snowman, and we'll keep up to date as what happens with that
as the weeks progress here on Championship Wrestling. We hope you've enjoyed all the action. Get out and see it. If you like it on TV, you'll love it in person. I promise you that. We'll be back next week with more U.S.